Hello guys, in this video tutorial I will explain that how you can find maximum likelihood estimation for the unknown parameter theta. In the previous video tutorial we explained that what is the maximum likelihood estimate and how we can calculate. There are two step procedure which we explained theoretically, and now I will explain this with the given data. For example, suppose we have data x1, x2, up to xn from some distribution, that is exponential distribution. In this case, random sample from exponential distribution with unknown parameter theta. Find the MLE of theta. This means that find the maximum likelihood estimate of the theta. So what we have, what are given with us, given as that xi is distributed exponentially with parameter theta. So now the procedure is we need to find the likelihood function, and then we need to calculate the log, natural log of the likelihood function, and then we need to use the two-step procedure to calculate the MLE. So the distribution of the x is suppose that is exponential, so f of x and theta is equal to theta e power minus theta x. This is the density function of the exponential distribution. The likelihood function is the product of the modern distribution of each observation, that is theta e power minus theta x1, theta e power minus theta x2, and up to theta e power minus theta xn. This means that we multiply theta n number of times, so that means this become equal to theta power n, and exponent theta summation xi, as we are summing the power and exponent. For example, on the side I can see, suppose minus x1 e power minus x2 e power minus xn, you can write this minus and minus common plus x1. This should be x1 plus x2 plus xn, and which is equal to e power minus summation xi from 1 to n. Okay, so now this is the likelihood function. Now I need to take the natural log. As I already told you there, the maximum value will be the same at the same point for the likelihood function as well as for the log likelihood function. So you do need to worry about this. We are taking natural log just to make simplified the function. So this is my notation for log likelihood. So taking natural log of the likelihood function, this is equal to natural log of this theta power n e power minus theta summation x, and using the properties of log, that this becomes n power is here, natural log of theta plus bracket minus theta summation x natural log e, which yields n natural log of theta minus theta summation x as log e is equal to 1. I will say natural log of e equal to 1. Okay, so now I have I'm ready for embarking on the two-step procedure, in which the first one is to calculate the first partial derivative with respect to the unknown parameter theta. So just calculate the first partial derivative of this function. This is equal to n divided by theta, because the derivative of natural log theta is 1 divided by e theta. So this is equal to n divided by theta minus summation x, and derivative of theta with respect to theta is equal to 1. This yields an equation of n divided by theta minus summation x. So this is equation t. Now we need to find the point at which the likelihood is the slope is 0 with respect to theta of the likelihood function. This means that we need to find the place at which the slope is 0, but that we are not sure at this point that whether it will be a maximum or minimum. Then we need to take to calculate the second step and verify that. So just equate this to 0, the first partial derivative, and solve for theta. This we can take LCM in this step, n minus theta summation x equal to 0, theta summation x is equal to n, theta equal to n divided by summation x, divided each, you know, in the numerator and denominator by n, this will yield theta equal to 1 divided by x bar. This is the point at which we can say the slope of the likelihood function as 0. But we are not sure whether it is a maximum point or a minimum point. For this purpose, we need to calculate the second partial derivative. This is the first partial derivative. Now we can take the second derivative with respect to theta, the likelihood function. So this, I'm just writing this for simplicity, theta, n theta power minus 1, and this is 1 over theta, so you can write theta power minus 1 minus summation x. And now you can take the derivative, so n into minus 1 theta power minus 2, this is just simply the roots in the derivative, minus, this is constant, so this is derivative 0. So second derivative is minus n divided by theta square. Okay, now this is the function, but we need to confirm whether it is less than 0 or not. Now to check whether second partial derivative with respect to theta is less than 0 or not. So what we do? We learn that we need to put the value of the theta we got in the first step in this expression, and we'll see whether it is less than 0 or not. If it is less than 0, then the point you got at the first partial derivative in the first step is the maximum likelihood estimate. So minus n divided by theta, that is 1 divided by x bar square. So this yield minus n x bar square, which is less than 0. Why less than 0? You can see the reason. Because n is the sum number of sample observation, which is of course greater than 0. And x bar is a square quantity, which is greater than 0. This means that this quantity is less than 0 because with the minus sign. So this n x bar square is a positive quantity, with the minus sign this become less than 0. Therefore theta hat equal to 1 divided by x bar, this is the point which we got at the first step, is the MLE of the parameter theta.